How to care for Abyssinian cats. The Abyssinian cat is a long-legged, muscular, and short-haired cat that usually has a fawn-colored coat. They are outgoing and active cats who love a lot of attention from their owners and are usually very smart. Like all cats, the Abyssinian cat needs proper care and nurturing to keep it happy and healthy. Part 1. Taking care of your cat's health. 1. Have a new cat screened for common diseases. When adopting a cat or kitten, have it looked over immediately for general health and breed-specific ailments. As a breed, the Abyssinian cat is prone to various diseases. This does not mean your Abyssinian will come down with a disease, as it may well live out a healthy disease-free life. However, it is wise to keep these tendencies in mind in case a problem arises. The diseases Abyssinians are prone to include: amyloidosis, heart disease, gum disease, nose polyps, myasthenia gravis, progressive retinal atrophy, psychogenic alopecia, hyperesthesia syndrome, hip dysplasia, patella kneecap luxation, congenital hypothyroidism, different from the more common hyperthyroidism in older cats. 2. Get your cat regular veterinary exams. In order to find any disease or condition at its earliest stage, it is advised to have twice yearly veterinary exams. Kittens generally see the veterinarian at least twice during the first 3 months of life, once more at around 5 to 6 months of age, and then follow the adult examination schedule. Your veterinarian will examine your cat thoroughly during the examination. This is the time to share any concerns or questions so they can be addressed promptly. Your Abyssinian's vaccinations will be updated, and a fecal examination will be performed in order to check for internal parasites. Each community has their different requirements and need for vaccinations, but the core vaccines are distemper and rabies. Feline leukemia vaccination may or may not be a part of its vaccinations depending upon your Abyssinian's lifestyle. If your cat is an outdoor cat, has been in contact with lots of other cats, such as at a shelter, or has potentially been in contact with a cat you know has feline leukemia, then it should get vaccinated. 3. Have your cat be sexed. You will need to decide if you will have your Abyssinian spayed, female, or neutered, male. This important operation has the benefits of reducing reproductive tract diseases and roaming or heat activity. It is also a community service, as it will help reduce the overall population of unwanted cats. If you do not plan on breeding your cat, you should definitely have your cat spayed or neutered. 4. Provide adequate dental care for your cat. Regular brushing reduces the plaque and buildup on the visible surfaces of the teeth. It's a simple, quick process that, after the learning period, takes less than a minute a day. To do so, you need a soft bristle toothbrush and veterinary toothpaste, both which can be purchased at pet stores or a veterinary clinic. Human toothpaste cannot be used as the fluoride in it is toxic to cats. The process is: place a small amount of the toothpaste on your fingertip and let your cat taste it. The following day do the same, then rub your finger along the cat's gums. The following day put the toothpaste on the brush and gently rub it along the cat's gums. For the next few days, slowly work the bristles along the teeth in small circles until your cat will sit still long enough for you to do the entire mouth.